Ben Affleck has faced his fair share of highs and lows over the years. Over decades in the spotlight, the actor and filmmaker has worked hard on sobriety, making movies, and, of course, finding love. Here's the timeline of Ben Affleck's most high-profile relationships. There's nothing quite like that first love. Thankfully, most people's first relationships don't end up like Romeo and Juliet, which, if you didn't already know, didn't turn out well. Movie star Ben Affleck's earliest known romance didn't start out in Tinseltown. It was in Boston, 1990, when he met his high school sweetheart, hometown girl Cheyenne Rothman, at a summer camp. Affleck and Rothman called it quits in 1997, the same year the actor blew up into a genuine movie star after the release of Good Will Hunting and started dating Gwyneth Paltrow. Draw your own conclusions there. So, yes, the man who would go on to hop from one serious partnership to another would start his dating life back home, naturally, with someone he had known for several years. For her part, Rothman would also get a consolation prize, a thanks in the credits for Affleck's Oscar-winning film Good Will Hunting. Just try and tell us that Hollywood's most famous and enduring modern bromance doesn't belong on this list. Ben Affleck and Matt Damon were childhood friends, and as Damon told ET in 2016, it was their mutual love of cinema that bonded them together. Damon explained, "We were both in love with the same thing, acting and filmmaking. I think we fed on each other's obsession during really formative, important years, and that bonded us for life." The two also come from humble beginnings. In 1992, after they got their first decent paychecks while co-starring in the film School Ties, the duo quickly blew all the cash and had to bounce around Los Angeles while they penned their breakout hit Good Will Hunting. Even as the film for which they eventually won matching Oscars was hitting movie theaters, the friends were so broke that they had to use a copy of the Variety, which said they were going to get $600,000 from the film as zero-down collateral to rent an apartment. From there, they developed their careers in showbiz side by side. Damon and Affleck remain close friends to this day. Ben Affleck and Gwyneth Paltrow met at a dinner party in 1997, thrown by the now-disgraced producer Harvey Weinstein. At the time, Paltrow was coming off her split from Brad Pitt and had started working with Affleck on Shakespeare in Love. As Paltrow told Howard Stern of her Oscar-winning turn, Weinstein, whom she later accused of sexual harassment, had oddly played matchmaker. At the time, Weinstein was trying to put all of his people in all of the movies. Though Paltrow graciously praised Affleck, with whom she split in 2000, as being intelligent and funny, she also told Stern that the future Batman actor, quote, "wasn't in a good place in his life to have a girlfriend." This wasn't the first time that Paltrow dropped some not-so-subtle dirt about Affleck. The Goop entrepreneur once told Good Morning America about her ex's aborted engagement to Jennifer Lopez and hinted that Affleck was the engineer of his own relationship issues. She said, "I just think we have a very different sort of value system. Ben makes life tough for himself. He's got a lot of complication, and, you know, he really is a great guy, so I hope he sorts himself out." Paltrow also alleged that, in her opinion, Affleck's perfect partner at the time would have been any sort of stripper at Scores. Anyone that serves cold beer in a bikini. You can almost feel bad for celebs who fall in love on a movie set. Between the long work days and being away from family and friends, pretending to be in love for the cameras can easily bleed into unscripted and sometimes disastrous reality. That seems to be the case with Ben Affleck and Jennifer Lopez, who met on the set of Geely in 2002. J-Lo was married at the time to her second husband, Chris Judd, but seemed to hit it off with Affleck right away regardless. As a movie, Geely was a bomb, both critically and commercially. But it did give rise to Bennifer, and a media frenzy ensued. Lopez said, "We just happened to be together at the birth of the tabloids, and it was like, oh my god, it was just a lot of pressure." Affleck went big in November 2002 with a custom-made Harry Winston pink diamond solitaire engagement ring. The two set a wedding date for September 2003, but postponed the ceremony just one day before the nuptials, citing excessive media attention as the reason for delaying the marriage. The paparazzi madness was so intense that they reportedly considered hiring decoy brides to distract the press at three different locations. The couple split in 2004, but remained friends, maybe even close friends, to this day. Ben Affleck and Jennifer Garner met while filming Pearl Harbor in 2000, but their romantic relationship didn't start right off the bat, as Garner was still married to actor Scott Foley. 2 years later, however, Affleck and Garner teamed up again for Daredevil. Affleck, who was still dating Jennifer Lopez, may have been playing a blind superhero, but he still had eyes for Garner, later admitting to Playboy that he fell in love with her on this set. Ben and Jen 2.0 went public with their romance in 2004. He proposed in 2005 on Garner's 33rd birthday, and they married each other in a private ceremony later that year. They now have 3 children together. However, trouble started in 2015, when Us Weekly reported that Affleck had taken the family's nanny, Christine Ouzounian, to Las Vegas for a mysterious and scandalous getaway. The magazine also asserted that he was full-on dating the nanny, a claim which Affleck's representative countered by saying, "The story is complete garbage and full of lies. We are considering legal options." Within a month, however, Affleck and Garner's divorce was announced. In 2016, Garner told Vanity Fair that the couple had been split for months before the alleged nanny incident. Meanwhile, Affleck blamed himself for the failure of the marriage, which he called the biggest regret of his life. He further admitted to the New York Times, "I started drinking more and more when my marriage was falling apart. My drinking, of course, created more marital problems." Ben Affleck gave the Hollywood power couple thing a solid go for several relationships, and even though the tabloids were all over him for it, it's understandable why. Many celebrities have spoken about the difficulty of dating someone who doesn't understand the scrutiny of superstardom. But in 2017, Affleck switched up his patterns when he went public with Emmy Award-winning Saturday Night Live producer Lindsay Shookus. Interestingly, though, a source speaking to Us Weekly said the relationship wasn't new, claiming Ben and Lindsay started their affair about 3 years ago, just a few months after she became a mom. They were not casually dating, they were having a full-blown affair. However, in August 2018, Affleck was seen on a date with Playboy model Shauna Sexton. A few days later, it was reported that Affleck's romance with the Saturday Night Live producer was over. For her part, Shookus had hinted to Elle earlier that year that she wasn't made for the spotlight, explaining, "My entire career has been behind the camera, and that's definitely where I'm most comfortable. I'm a producer, I'm a mom, a friend. Being considered a public figure honestly makes me laugh." At this point, Ben Affleck gives the impression of a man who starts a relationship, gets bored around the 2-year mark, and then strays into the next fling. That assessment may not be far off. Speaking in an interview with the New York Times in 2020, Affleck said, "People with compulsive behavior, and I am one, have this kind of basic discomfort all the time that they're trying to make go away. You're trying to make yourself feel better with eating, or drinking, or sex, or gambling, or shopping, or whatever. But that ends up making your life worse. It becomes a vicious cycle you can't break." Enter Playboy model Shauna Sexton in 2018, when Affleck was still, as far as anyone knew, involved with Saturday Night Live producer Lindsay Shookus. Only 22 years old at the time, Sexton and Affleck first got together at Los Angeles eatery Nobu on August 16th, but hit a snag when Affleck checked into rehab shortly after. When he checked out, Affleck took Sexton to Montana, but soon after, a source claimed to People that their so-called casual relationship was done. He enjoyed being with her, but is working on himself, and being together with her at this time is not something that works. Ben Affleck and Ana De Armas were first spotted together in Havana in March 2020. De Armas is native to Cuba, perhaps suggesting the affair was already underway at the time they were first spotted. It's possible the duo met while filming the movie Deep Water. They later were spotted kissing during reshoots that November, and by the following month, the Blade Runner 2049 star had listed her Venice, California home for sale and moved into Affleck's place in Pacific Palisades. The whirlwind romance was documented in many public displays of affection. De Armas was seen hanging out with Affleck's kids, and the two even went extremely Instagram official. Not to mention, De Armas also got to meet Affleck's longtime pal Matt Damon, and was reportedly helping her famous beau stay sober. One source cited by E! Explained, "Since Ana has been in Ben's life, being sober has become easier to manage. Drinking isn't part of the equation with Ana." Then, suddenly in January 2021, it was all over. An insider told People, "Ben is no longer dating Ana. She broke it off. Ana doesn't want to be Los Angeles based, and Ben obviously has to since his kids live in Los Angeles." Well, it was good while it lasted. With Ana De Armas out of his life, was Ben Affleck craving the familiar comfort of an old flame? Maybe. To be fair, it seemed as though Jennifer Lopez had her own reasons to meet with the actor, too. In mid-April 2021, J.Lo called off her engagement to former baseball star Alex Rodriguez and split with the slugger for good, releasing a boilerplate statement about being, quote, better as friends. Sources later claimed that the breakup was a long time coming. Rumors of cheating regarding A-Rod had swirled for months, and Lopez admitted to Allure in February 2021 that the duo had sought couples counseling. But in the end, the power couple's twice postponed nuptials turned out to be an ominous sign of where things were going for the relationship. 2 weeks later, Affleck was spotted getting into Lopez's white Escalade and chauffeured to her Los Angeles mansion. Though the two weren't actually spotted together, Lopez and Affleck reportedly hung out three times around this time, spurring even more rumors, with an insider noting to Page Six, "They are friends. They've never not been." Just before Jennifer Lopez's split with Alex Rodriguez, Ben Affleck mused to InStyle that his ex-girlfriend superstar is, quote, "the hardest-working person I've come across in this business." He amusingly directed toward J.Lo when he said, "Where are you keeping the fountain of youth? Why do you look the same as you did in 2003? And it kind of looks like I'm in my 40s, at best." It's in that mindset that this A-list movie star reportedly had a near miss with a TikTok microstar. In 2021, the newly single Affleck reportedly found himself on the dating app Raya, which describes itself as an online membership-based community for dating, networking, and making new friends. The site has more aptly been called Illuminati Tinder, where only the most elite and connected singles are invited to mingle. Affleck allegedly matched with Raya user Naveen J, who quickly deleted him, assuming that the Ben Affleck account was just a fake. He then reportedly sent her a video proving it was him. She made a TikTok video about the encounter, which went viral that May. She wrote on her post, "Thinking of the time I matched with Ben Affleck on Raya and thought it was fake, so I unmatched him and he sent me a video on Instagram." She then played Affleck's clip, in which he follows up with her while flashing his wry movie star smile. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite celebrities are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.